ट्रांसक्रिप्शन नंबर 18, 80 वर्ड्स पर मिनट, 800 वर्ड्स स्टार्ट. ही मेड प्लान्स टू गो टू द USA फॉर बेटर जॉब प्रॉस्पेक्ट्स एंड वाइल कंटिन्यूइंग टू वर्क इन द कोचिंग सेंटर ही ऑल्सो ऑब्टेंड अ पासपोर्ट इन हिज नेम. बट आफ्टर ए फ्यू मंथ्स ऑफ मैरिज frictions arose between him and his wife. She did not cooperate with him at the time of sex and used to pick up quarrels with him on several issues. She would complain about the stay of his brother with them and would strongly oppose his sending any money to his parents. She did not seem to care much for him or his work, and despite persuasions by him, showed no interest in learning computer. Distressed by the unhappiness of his matrimonial life, he thought of taking his own life, and with that intention procured from his friend Brahmachari, who was a goldsmith, some cyanide on the pretext that he needed it for cleaning the computer parts. He kept the cyanide at a concealed place at their residence in Hyderabad. At that time, he got an opportunity to go to the USA through the Macro Technology Company, and he told his wife that he would go first and then call her there after a year. But she insisted on accompanying him. He even told her that he would call her to America only after 3 months of his going there. But she would not listen and insisted that he must take her along with him. Completely exasperated by his wife's nagging, he thought of killing her rather than giving up his own life. He then decided to kill her by administering the poison that lay hidden at their residence and waited for a suitable chance to give her the poison. On August 22, 2000, his wife went to her native place to attend the marriage of her elder brother, and she returned back to Hyderabad on September 1, 2000. During her absence from the house, he had decided to kill her within the shortest possible time, as he had to go to the USA in the month of October 2000. In the night of September 1, 2000, his brother-in-law Prashad stayed in his house. That night he was completely unable to sleep, and he kept on thinking of ways to kill his wife by giving her cyanide. On the following day, at about 2:30 in the afternoon, He returned from the computer center. His brother-in-law had already left the house in the morning. At around 4 in the afternoon, his wife said she wanted to have a cold drink, and this suddenly gave him the idea to give her the poison by mixing it in the cold drink. He took out the cyanide packet from the place where it was hidden and went to a nearby general store from where he purchased a bottle of Limca. He got the bottle opened and on the way back went inside a STD booth where he put some cyanide into the opened cold drink bottle. At around 4:30 p.m., he arrived back at his house and gave the cold drink spiked with cyanide to his wife. His wife asked him to have some cold drink from that bottle, but he declined the offer and left the house saying that he had some urgent work at the computer center. On the way to the institute, he threw away the remaining cyanide in a nala. He was sure that his wife would consume the poisoned cold drink and would die. At about 6 p.m., he received the message at his office that his wife was seriously ill and was admitted to Maitri Hospital. He knew that his wife would die. He went to the hospital and found his wife in unconscious state. He feigned ignorance about the reason for her feeling ill. He rushed back to his house and found the Limca bottle by the side of the sofa. It was still contained about half of its contents. He threw away the remaining contents of the bottle in the bathroom and concealed the bottle on the bedroom shelf. Then he again went to the hospital. In the meanwhile, some of his relatives had sent the message to his in-laws. On September 3, his in-laws reached the hospital. On the same day, around 8 p.m., the doctors declared his wife dead. On the death of his wife, his in-laws got agitated. They expressed doubt about the cause of her death and cast suspicion on him. Seeing the turn of the events, he went away from the hospital. On the following morning, he came to know that the police was searching for him. He decided to escape from Hyderabad and go to his village. He was waiting near the electricity office Amir Pate to meet the MD of his computer institute. Stop.